Workers at the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear plant in northeastern Japan are scrambling to figure out how to fix a problem that could have dangerous consequences. The system that cools hundreds of spent fuel rods stored at the facility has stopped working. Spokespersons for the operator Tokyo Electric Power Company say they had a partial power failure on Monday in the early evening. After that, they discovered a problem with an electricity supply unit. Right now, cooling systems for the spent fuel pools in reactors 1, 3, and 4 are not operating. TEPCO representatives say temperatures are rising slowly but are still at a normal level. They say they don't know how to fix this problem. But they also point out they have several days to come up with a solution. There are hundreds of spent fuel rods stored at Fukushima Daiichi, a separate system that's keeping the melted fuel in reactors 1, 2, and 3 cool is still working. TEPCO spokespersons say the level of radiation around Fukushima Daiichi has not changed.
Disaster management officials in Japan have released some statistics they know are shocking, but that they hope will help people prepare. They say damage from an earthquake that's expected to hit any time could reach $2.3 trillion in a worst-case scenario. That's more than twice the current national budget. Scientists warn the Nankai Trough south of Japan's main island could trigger a magnitude 8.1 earthquake. They say the probability of it happening sometime in the next 30 years is 70 to 80%. Disaster management officials say in the worst-case scenario, the quake and resulting tsunami would kill more than 300,000 people. Nearly 10 million others would need to take shelter because electricity and water supplies would be disrupted. Officials say damage to housing, businesses, and factories could top $1.5 trillion. Another $210 billion would have to be spent to repair roads and railways.
We have taken the worst-case scenario to improve our crisis management. The figures are severe, but we want the public to understand, in a calm manner, what would happen if a megaquake occurred.
Officials plan to compile new strategies within a year to minimize possible damage.
Researchers say contaminated water from the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear plant could still be leaking into the port. They're calling for a thorough investigation.
A team from Tokyo University of Marine Science and Technology has been studying the seawater in a port directly in front of the plant. Tests show levels of radioactive cesium exceed the government safety standard in some places. Researchers have calculated the total amount of radioactive substances in the port over a one-year period. They say about 16 trillion becquerels of cesium-137 may have leaked into the ocean since June 2011. That's 73 times the discharge limit imposed before the nuclear accident. Experts say that amount of contamination doesn't pose a threat to marine life in open waters. But radioactive substances could accumulate in fish in the port. Radioactive water began leaking into the ocean after the 2011 nuclear accident. Officials at Tokyo Electric Power took steps. They say the leak stopped 3 months later. Research team professor Jota Kanda says contaminated water may be leaking as groundwater. He says another possibility is damaged pipes in the compound.
We need to look into every single possibility to verify the cause, if in fact contaminated water is leaking.
But it's probably best if we just ignore what they're about to say.
TEPCO officials say they don't think radioactive substances are leaking. They say they will continue to investigate.
Representatives for the pro-gun group told the public they would be better off paying no attention to any part of the statement.
Less than 1% of food in Japan has been found to contain radioactive cesium above the legal limit since the nuclear disaster. The current standard for staples such as vegetables, rice and fish is 100 becquerels of cesium per kilogram. The limit for baby food and milk is 50 becquerels, while that for drinking water is 10 becquerels. Health Ministry officials say 17 prefectures conducted tests on more than 250,000 items between April and the end of February. They say cesium limits were exceeded in about 2,200 cases, or nearly 0.9% of the total. Fish, including greenling and sole, were found to be above the cesium limit in more than 1,000 cases. Fresh produce, including shiitake mushrooms and bamboo shoots, was found to have exceeded the limit in just over 630 cases. The government orders compulsory withdrawal of a food item if excess contamination is found in a wide area or in multiple locations. As of March 5th, more than 130 food products from 14 prefectures have been removed from distribution.
On the second anniversary of the disaster, about 1,600 people affected by the nuclear accident have filed lawsuits against the government and Tokyo Electric Power Company. They're demanding compensation for the suffering and losses incurred after the meltdowns at Fukushima Daiichi. Most of the plaintiffs are from Fukushima, but they also include residents from neighboring prefectures. Many had to evacuate their homes because of radioactive contamination. Several lawsuits were filed on the same day at the district courts in Fukushima, Chiba, and Tokyo. Plaintiffs in Fukushima are demanding that their region be restored to its condition before the accident.
Financial compensation is at a standstill because we've all suffered from the disaster in different ways. But it's also because the liability of TEPCO and the Japanese government hasn't been established.
Total compensation claims filed through the courts amount to about $55 million.
The tsunami washed mountains of debris into the Pacific Ocean. Officials with Japan's Environment Ministry say tons will start washing ashore in North America next month. The officials used a computer simulation to figure out how quickly the wreckage is moving. They think more than 100,000 tons will reach the North American coastline by June and more than 200,000 tons by October. The officials think the tsunami swept 1.5 million tons of wreckage into the ocean. Some of that wreckage has washed up on coastlines in North America and Hawaii. Japanese leaders have given $6 million to U.S. and Canadian officials to help them deal with it. They say they'll hand over the results of their computer simulation to help communities deal with more.
Forecasters at Japan's Meteorological Agency plan to post new information online later this month in the event of a major earthquake strikes. The service will give data about the effects of long-period ground motion on tall buildings. Major tremors can rock high-rises far from the epicenter for several minutes. The forecasters will release information about the effects of ground motion on buildings of 14 stories or more as soon as an earthquake occurs. The intensity of the motion will be ranked on a scale of 1 to 4. At levels 1 and 2, shaking will be felt, but is unlikely to cause structural damage. At 3, people would find it hard to remain standing. And at 4, walls would start cracking and people would be forced to crawl to get around. Forecasters want the information to help protect those living or working in buildings that are more than 45 meters high. They say long period motion causes swaying that is stronger the higher people are in a building. Scientists warn the Nankai Trough south of Japan's main island could trigger a magnitude 8.1 earthquake. They say the probability of it happening sometime in the next 30 years is 70 to 80%.
Some local governments in Japan with nuclear plants in their jurisdiction will likely miss Monday's deadline for reviewing their disaster control plans. Other municipalities have already finished the process but have yet to draw up concrete evacuation plans. In light of the 2011 nuclear crisis, the Nuclear Regulation Authority ordered municipalities within a 30-kilometer radius of a nuclear power plant to review their disaster control measures based on new sets of guidelines. These call for evacuation areas around nuclear plants to be expanded from the current 10 kilometers to 30. They also require evacuation or stay-at-home orders to be issued based on radiation dosage. An NHK survey shows only 46% of local governments said they will be able to finish reviewing their disaster control plans to meet the deadline. Some municipalities say the central government was too late in revising the guidelines and providing explanations necessary for them to review their community-based plans. Others say they haven't decided where to evacuate residents or don't have the means to evacuate a large number of people.
You set the spark, you stoke the fire, and then you act surprised. When the flames go up, when the barn comes down, right there before your eyes. Oh, the tools that you manipulate are more powerful each day. And they will overcome you, they'll crush you and take from you all the marrow and the sinew of your ideology. But don't get upset, don't be like that. It's your own damn fault that your flock is ready to fight. It is too late to turn around, turn them all to salt. No, your monsters come to life. Oh, well, rocks are thrown and voices used to tear down the innocent. People will die with ideas cast in rebar stoked cement. Oh, the words you shout has moved the herd to break free from their cage, to drop bombs on all the weaklings, retching, melting, reeking of the forfeit tired teachings of your ideology. But don't get upset, you can't be like that, 'cause it's your damn fault that your flock is ready to fight. It is too late to turn around, to turn them all to salt. No, your monsters come to life. Oh, don't get upset, don't be like that. It's your own damn fault, yeah, that your flock is ready to fight. It is too late to turn around, to turn them all to salt. No, your monsters come to life. Whoa, whoa, it's come to life. You set the spark, you stoke the fire, and then you act surprised. When the flames go up, when the barn comes down, right there before your eyes. Oh, the tools that you manipulate are more powerful each day. And they will overcome you, they'll crush you and take from you all the marrow and the sinew of your ideology. But don't get upset, don't be like that. It's your own damn fault that your flock is ready to fight. It is too late to turn around, turn them all to salt. No, your monsters come to life.